I love you, Allah.
Have you ever asked yourself what type of people that Allah loves? You know, I'm sure that Allah does not, you know, hate anyone, but it depends on our deeds. I'm also sure and certain there are certain people whom Allah loves. Now, you don't have to wonder anymore, because one of the companions of the Prophet had exactly the same question that you may ask or you may have right now. This companion, he came to the Prophet and he said, "O Prophet of Allah, tell me the type of people whom Allah would love them or Allah loves them." Now, again, if you reflect on our daily life, you know, you may consider that question not that relevant or that significant. But if you're a righteous person and you want to be close to God or close to Allah, you want to be near your Creator, you want Him to love you, these are the type of questions that you should be asking. So this man, this companion of the Prophet, comes to the Messenger of Allah and he says to him, "O Prophet of Allah, tell me the type of people whom Allah loves." Now keep in mind, when he said types of people, he did not mean, you know, tall or short, you know, wide or narrow or fat or skinny, you know, black or white or brown. He meant type of people spiritually who are closer to God and God loves them. So the Prophet said to him, "The people that Allah loves them most are those who are good to others." See, you never thought of that. You thought the Prophet may say, well, the people that God loves are those who are wealthy, or those who have degrees, your PhDs on the wall, you know, doing certain things, those who are strong physically and mentally, those, you know, you can run fast, who can read fast, who can, you know, do certain things. But God has a different measurement in terms of measuring what He likes and what He loves and what He dislikes. Now here the Prophet said in Arabic, I will say so you can understand, he said, "Ahabbu an-nasi ila Allah, anfa'uhum lin-nas." He said the people whom Allah loves most are those who will benefit others most. Wow. Now again, he did not say God loves Muslims alone, or believers or mu'mineen alone, or those who will benefit the believers, who will benefit the Muslims, but he said God loves those who will benefit others. Now, number one, we rule out one thing, and that is, if you are out there to hurt others, to harm others, then God would not love you. Because he says, the Prophet of Allah said, God loves those who would benefit others. So what kind of benefit are we talking about? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned general benefits. It can be anything. It could be that you go out of your house, knowing your neighbor is an elderly person, he or she is struggling, you know, shoveling this snow, and you go out of your house, you get out of your comfort, and you say to this elderly person, this, you know, your neighbor, say, "You know what, relax, I'll remove this snow for you out of the driveway today." Or you will say, "You know, it's summertime, let me cut the grass for you, let me do it for you." See, those acts are the acts that God will love you for, because you are going to benefit someone else. You're young, you're fit, you're strong, you're fast, you know, you can do a lot of things. You see this old lady pushing a, you know, shopping cart, and she's trying to unload things into her car. And you come around and you stop and say, "Good evening, ma'am," or "Good evening, sir," in a nice and beautiful manner. And you help that person out. And you take that car and you put where it belongs. And you say, "Thank you very much for allowing me to serve you, for allowing me to help you, for allowing me to be your aid and to be there for you." Now, when you do this, God will love you. Allah will love you. When you go and you feed a needy person, God will love you. Allah will love you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, people whom Allah loves are those who will benefit the people most.